Here I go now. Here I go in soon.
TV. My name is Chris Bloss, and I'm enjoying my last few weeks here on the West Coast, home of movie stars, swimming pools before I'm forced to relocate to the East Coast, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the home of Steel Productions and the franchise Shane Douglas. This week, we're going to take a look back at Night of Champions. We're going to take a look back at Webb. Final match here in XPW, as well as take a look back at the King of the Deathmatch Tournament. More brutal action. Don't go away, fans. More action coming up here on XPW TV.
No, Gloria, I want everything. I want Extreme Associates, Armageddon, Overkill. Which way are you going, you bitch? I want the websites, the leather company, XPW. No, I want it all, and I want the cars. Yes, the cars and both vacation homes. God, all these hanging out. Ugh. Yes, everything. Okay, call me back. Bye.
We know that Supreme ended up winning the XPW King of the Deathmatch title with the assist of the franchise Shane Douglas and some tranquilizer darts. But eight other men gave it their all in an attempt to become king at Night of Champions right now. Let's take a look at the first round match between Steve Rizzono and Crimson.
And yes, it's Steve Rizzono coming to the ring. We saw him last year take a huge, horrific beating in the tournament. And once again, has this guy learned? Look at the way he's dressed. All he's got is traditional ring trunks, and he's going into a deathmatch tournament? This guy is nuts. What's he doing? Rizzono going behind this car. This very shady looking car. A possible game of peekaboo hide and go seek. Telling everybody to shush. Rizzono hiding behind the car. What is this? Oh my goodness, oh no, it's Crimson. Crimson, and here comes Rizzono. Look at this, from the top, double axe handle behind. Crimson is Rizzono. Go crashing down to the dirt. And now look at this Irish whip, no, into the station wagon, off. Right into the station wagon. Ron Head joining us once again, unfortunately, at the ringside area. Now another Irish whip on the dirt. Look at this. Crimson with the reversal. Oh, small the back right into the Chevy.
I should point out that Steve Rizzono, representing the Enterprise once again, is fighting in this tournament with no shirt, just in tight.
Just like he did last year, Ron Head.
And slid over the hood of the car into the dirt. The dirt where the bulls ride in Pico Rivera. Crimson is not giving him a chance to get his momentum started, and they're back on. Whose car is that anyway?
I believe it's International Talent Scouts Tony T's, perhaps.
Tony T better watch out. Trying to put together ChrisGloss.com here.
Look at this now. Look at this.
Is he going to pile drive? Is he going to power bomb him on the roof of the car?
You've got to be kidding me. Wait a minute. Back body drop. Oh, no.
A backdrop onto the hood, almost putting a sunroof into Tony T's roof. Crimson now. That man is psychotic and deranged, bloodthirsty.
Oh, look at that elbow right to the back.
And
of Steve Rizzono from the hood of the car onto all the dirt. All the duck poo-poo out here at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena.
I'm not sure where that smell came from. Thought it may have been
You got the duck farms everywhere, buddy, out here. And look at this. Shot now right to the head from Crimson onto Steve Rizzono, the Gigolo, member of the Enterprise.
Still, they have not made their way into the death match ring, the ring with the bed of thumbtacks.
Oh, no! Oh, look at that! Steve Rizzono!
Into fluorescent light tubes, detonating the flesh, again exposed, and already the chest and maybe the jaw sliced open.
Look at this crutch to the back! Rizzono! Why the hell did he come out in that attire?
Steve Rizzono is bleeding from the mouth.
Oh!
Maybe internal bleeding. And that recyclable Alhambra water bottle.
And look out. Look out. The announce table. In the danger zone. Danger zone now. And look at the blood flowing from the face of Rizzono. Where it's coming from, I don't know if it's extra internal. Very
Steve
good
Rizzono.
Question. Rizzono sort of weapon he can get his hands on right now. Rizzono with the cookie sheet in hand. Look at this now.
Metal cookie sheet.
Look at this. Oh no, boot to the midsection counter from Crimson. And now we're getting nasty. Now
that
we're getting
crutch.
Dirty. Oh, look at this. That crutch. Draped.
That dropped in barbed wire with glass. Barbed wire with glass on exposed flesh. And Steve Rizzono is gushing blood.
My God, listen to that man, Crimson. Listen to him.
These fans could not be happier. These are the sickest bunch of fans.
Oh!
What was that, a Sony PlayStation?
I believe so.
Look at the marks left on the back of Steve Rizzono.
Look at the marks on the back, indeed.
I'm talking about pain. You want to talk about pain, you get in there with barbed wire. They're going to rocket launch him.
Oh, look at this. Look at this, the bed of barbed wire. No, no. Oh, Rizzono.
Breast slam onto a board of flesh-shredding barbed wire, the agony that Steve Rizzono must be in. And look.
Wait a minute. Pogo the Clown.
Pogo the Clown.
Look at this. Go going right after Crimson. Both these men, these monsters. What the hell is Pogo doing out here, Ronhead? What the hell is he doing out here?
Gloss, Pogo must be very bitter in losing his chance at getting the tag team championship earlier. Is he putting himself in the deathmatch tournament?
I don't know. Obviously, the referee letting it go. I mean, pound for pound, these men match up so well with one another.
Look at the thousands of thumbtacks that can penetrate and sink into skin and meat and bone. Pogo the Clown is taking Crimson, launching him all the way out to the floor here, where barbed wire, where glass, where tacks, where all sorts of carnage is on the loose here. And Pogo the Clown, Chris Kloss, Pogo the Clown, I'm getting deja vu to last year's King of the Deathmatch Championship.
Wait a minute, we're not going to go to deja vu until after the show, Ronhead. Wait a minute, now look at this. Rizzono, yeah, exactly, last year these two men were in the tournament against one another, and look at this powerbomb coming up. Oh no, you've got to be kidding me. Oh my God, did you see the impact? One, two, that's it, it's over.
And it's the Clown advancing.
Indeed, Pogo advancing in the tournament. Oh no, look at this, Crimson from behind with a steel chair. Pogo goes down.
Crimson not finished with him. Not happy, the opportunity taken away from him. And oh, Kloss, I know you hate to relive memories like this, but he's
please.
Going for that razor-sharp X-Acto blade.
This guy's sick. This guy's demented. Both these men are. But I think Crimson even more so than Pogo the Clown.
And you know firsthand just what it feels like to be sliced open. A steel chair!
Please don't remind me.
Onto the back of Pogo the Clown, who has put himself in this tournament, and he will be advancing. He's cutting Pogo's head with the X-Acto blade. Pogo the Clown is guts and blood. This is the first time I can ever remember Pogo the Clown being split
open
ever.
Look at the face of Pogo. Pogo completely busted wide open.
And he's taking Pogo's blood once again, like everyone else, smearing the blood onto the mask. Pogo the Clown winning, advancing, but covered in, as Gordon Sully would say, a crimson mask. Crimson.
No pun intended, I hope. Pogo the Clown coming over to the announce table.
The guys in everywhere.
This guy, I mean, he's taking a beating, but it's Pogo who advances in the tournament. And Crimson's got to be very upset, and he showed it just minutes ago.
Well, Pogo the Clown not slowing down one bit after his opportunity. Oh, look at Rizzono, just his face internally, maybe his mouth. Oh, this is nauseating.
This is nauseating, but Rizzono giving his all. You got to give it up for the guy. But the bottom line is, the big story is, Pogo the Clown has advanced in the King of the Deathmatch Tournament. And what a match that was.
All right, Gloria, come on, work with me a little bit, will you? Just get an Armageddon, Overkill, XPW, the house in the Hamptons. Let him keep the condo in Nantucket. He really loves that condo in Nantucket. Work with me. How could you say no? Give me a chance. Come on, let's go out to dinner. Let's go out to dinner Sunday. We'll talk about it. What do you say? Just you and me. We'll do some negotiating. Well, I didn't mean to insult you. All right, no condo in Nantucket. I'll tell him all the bad news when he gets here. You've been a lot of help. Thank you.
So Pogo the Clown's very upset about not winning the XPW World Tag Team titles at Night of Champions. No thanks to my former broadcast partner, Wantastico, who I haven't seen or heard from since his beatdown at Night of Champions. Pogo interjecting himself in the tournament to advance, much like Supreme did to him and Rizzono in the last year's tournament. Now, we're going to see that match, Angel versus Pogo, next week. But when we return, fans, we're going to take a look at Shane Douglas as he goes against Webb for the XPW World Heavyweight title.
He did what? He asked you to go to dinner? He is such a sleaze bucket. Ugh. Go figure Robert has that kind of lawyer. What? Oh, no. I already told you, I will not compromise. I want the vacation home in Nantucket. He's not gonna get it. I'm the one that loves the vacation home in Nantucket, not him. He's such a bullshit, such like a little baby. He does not want it. He just wants it because I want it. No, you... God, I can't figure out what my mom is. You get me that vacation home. I don't care what you do. Do whatever you have to do, but that's... He is not getting the vacation home in Nantucket. All right, well, I gotta get to the mall because Shane wants me to get some new sheets. All right, bye.
What's up, man?
How you doing?
Dude, tell me you got some good news.
I got some good news for you.
Oh, man.
You want the good news? I'll give you the good news. Right? You get everything until September 1st. After September 1st, she gets Armageddon, Overkill, XPW, the house in the Hamptons, the condo in Nantucket.
Oh, I love that condo.
You love that condo no more. But you get Extreme Associates.
What else?
That's it, man. And what you're wearing on your back, because it looks like it's got the closet, too. That's what you're wearing.
Come on, what else?
That's it.
You're joking with me.
That's it.
Come on.
It's California, man. You guys have been together for a while. She got Lori Aldridge. You got me.
Yeah, but so? Come on.
Go on, you know. This is it. That's it. Split it in half. It's split right in half. So that's what you end up with.
So I'd be $600 an hour. This is what I get?
Yeah. $700 an hour, maybe I got you overkill.
Who's that?
That's one of my clients. That's Ice. That's Ice and the King. Handle a few things for them.
So you handle them? Look, he looks like he's living large. And what do I got? I got a pair of jean shorts and a shirt. He's living good. What do I got? I got nothing.
Everybody got their own little worlds, man. This is yours. You're dealing with right now. So you got Extreme, though, and that's something.
Well, when does all this take place?
September 1st. Like I told you, that's some good news. So you keep control for a couple of days, for a couple of weeks, you get. So
I'm kind of like a lame duck president.
Yeah, you said it.
But I could still do stuff.
You still have control. You could do whatever you want.
All right, so I could go into the bank accounts and grab all the money.
Yes, Lizzie and Shane already got that taken care of. They already took care of that.
So what do I got? I got nothing.
That's it, man. That's it. What you get is what you get. That's it. It's California. If we were in New York, it'd be a whole different story, but we're not. It's California, my friend.
All right, so September 1st.
You got to take the lumps.
Solved. $600 an hour, and this is what I get. I get lumps.
Because you ended up with Extreme Associates. It just says on your arm. That's what you get, man. That's what you got.
September 1st. And they got all the money.
They got everything already. They got everything.
You know where I'm living?
Where you living?
All right. You know Webb?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm living with him in this apartment, all right? And he's got a dog, all right? This pit bull. His name's Angus, and it just it's all over the apartment.
Jump around.
I'm living in Saul.
We gotta do something, man.
I know Ice-T ain't living in
He's got a show on Channel 2 also. We don't want to tell you. You know, he's got his TV show happening.
September 1st,
you gotta be September 1st. You control everything till September 1st. September 1st, everything else goes into effect. You know, it's not easy dealing with that broad, that Aldridge broad, you know?
Bitch.
Not like I could take her out to dinner, wine her and dine her and give her a little something, you know what I mean? She's not up for that.
She's a lesbian.
Well, she might be, but I don't want to say. She didn't want a piece of her song, so. But you still have control until September 1st. September 1st, you get Extreme. But you gotta look up the positive, you know? Look at the positive, you get something. Better than nothing.
She broke my heart, Saul.
Happens to the best of us.
You know, I figured this. I mean, Shane? I mean, come on. You know, I had this friend, all right? I had this friend who was devoted and married to this girl. And, like, she went off, all right? And, like, hung out with, like, a surfer, all right? All right, Saul?
Yeah.
Okay, and I thought that was bad, But for Shane Douglas, she leaves you for Shane Douglas? There's a little... I gave her the world. I created Lizzie Borden. That's what I get. I'd rather have her go with a surfer.
This is what you got.
Hey, okay, I'm going.
Alright, try to have a good day.
He's having a good day. Ice-T's having a good day.
And I sent some bills out to the office. Can you take care of those for me, please?
Yeah, Dad, have me talk to Dave.
Alright. Take care of yourself, man. Do the best. Keep your head up.
Folks, it's been an interesting week here. Rob Black has been meeting with his lawyers, Lizzie, with hers. And I hear it's getting very, very ugly. Now, none of this would have been possible without the swerve Shane Douglas pulled at Night of Champions. Right now, let's take you back to Night of Champions to see the King of the Guard.
With a 60-minute time limit, and it is for the XPW World Heavyweight Championship, your referee, Patrick Hernandez.
But the big question is, who has Veronica been selected from the Enterprise to go against Webb? Will it be Rizzono? Will it be Sandman? Will it be GQ Money? Or will it be Chaos? And Lizzie Borden, of course, still suffering at the hands of that near fatal explosion, that accident that she had as world champion. Webb looks very, very focused, yet at the same time, very concerned. XPW CEO Rob Black escorting his wife, Lizzie Borden, still the very lovely Lizzie Borden. This what her face must look like right now. And for her to be out of the house, it's remarkable. Webb now circling the ringside as World Heavyweight Champion. World Heavyweight Champion Webb now getting set for battle. He's going to be defending the World Heavyweight Championship, well, against, once again, a mystery opponent. Who it is, we don't know, but Webb, the world champ right now, circling the broadcast of Webb. Okay, thank you very much. Well, Webb, I think he's got to focus on his match and not focus on my broadcast calling and not focus, well, on Lizzie Borden, on Rob Black. He's got to focus right now. He doesn't know what to focus on. I don't know who he's going to focus on either. Maybe he's done his homework on all the Enterprise members. Who knows? Nonetheless, the XPW World title is on the line tonight at Night of Champions. Well, now we await the mystery opponent. Who it is, I don't know. Lizzie Borden. And yes, it's Chaos. Big surprise. Yes, there he is, the world TV title holder. Chaos will be going against Webb. It's champion versus champion. The world title is on the line. Webb, Chaos. We'll battle it out for the undisputed XPW World Heavyweight title. Look at Chaos still suffering from this last battle he had with the TV title match. Him and Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick. And folks, right now, we don't know the state of Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick, but when he landed along with Chaos, Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick, well, seriously injured. What is this? Wait just a minute. Oh, wait, Veronica Kane. Well, obviously, here she comes. And she obviously selected Chaos to be the challenger for the world title. I mean, I can't say that I blame her, because Chaos definitely having the credentials to take the title. But what is she doing here? What is this? And now Webb looks concerned. Wait, Veronica Kane saying...
I've been making phone calls, been spending a little time on the phone. Rob Black, you're not a very smart man to let me have my choice of Enterprise members. You didn't say current Enterprise members.
Current? What's she talking about?
I brought a legend. I brought a champion to be my champion.
A champion to be her champ? What is she talking about?
XPW fans, let's welcome the newest member of the Enterprise.
Who? Wait just a minute! Don't tell me! Don't tell me he's back! Wait a minute. Oh. The franchise Shane Douglas! The franchise Shane Douglas! The franchise Shane Douglas is back at XPW! I can't believe it! I can't believe it! The franchise is back at XPW! Shane Douglas, the franchise who put XPW on the map, is back! He's back, ladies and gentlemen! And he's obviously, apparently, the newest member of the E! Rob Black, he can't believe it. This was supposed to be Rob Black's big night. His big triumphant return.
Lizzie Borden and Rob Black is the current reigning and defending XPW World Heavyweight Champion. He is the king. He is accompanied to the ring by Enterprise members Veronica Kane and Chaos. He is from Pittsburgh, California, Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the franchise, Shane Douglas!
The franchise, Shane Douglas, he is here at XPW. And he's going after Webb's XPW World Heavyweight title. I never would have ever thunk that I'd see the day that the franchise Shane Douglas will be back in XPW. The franchise Shane Douglas, yes, he is back. And look at this Webb. I can't believe it. Webb can't believe it. Look at the eyes. Look at Webb. I've never seen that look in his face before. Webb can't believe it. I can't believe it. These fans are in awe. The franchise, Shane Douglas, the man who put this company on the map, is back in XPW, and he's going after the World Heavyweight title.
And it looks like this match is about to get underway. Referee Patrick Hernandez now telling Shane Douglas he's got to watch his cast. Yes, he has a cast on his right arm, right forearm, and now this match is getting underway. Webb wants to go for a test of strength here. Shane Douglas. Oh, wait a minute. Correction. Test of stench. Webb's hand is soiled. It's soiled, ladies and gentlemen. And now the left hand as well. Both are soiled. Oh, look at this. Webb playing mind games. Going right after Shane Douglas. Double axe handle to the shoulder. Kicks now. A few of them to the midsection. And now shots right to the head. Fist as Shane Douglas backed up on the near side. Irish whip perhaps coming up. Yes. Shane Douglas to the far side. And look at the clothesline. And Shane Douglas goes down. But Webb, look at this. Webb may have hurt his knee. He's had some injuries in the past as far as his knee's concerned. And Webb has had a long reign, ladies and gentlemen, as XPW World Champion since August of 2001. He's beat Sabu. He's beat Vampiro. He's beat the Sandman. But this has got to be his toughest bout to date. And Shane Douglas now standoffish. He doesn't want to have anything to do with all the weaponry around the ring here for the Deathmatch Tournament. And Webb missing the dropkick. Shane just barely getting out of the way. Oh, wait a minute. Look at this. Shane Douglas now with Webb in a very compromising position. Shane Douglas, the man who can walk out of here tonight with the XPW title around his waist. What is this now? He's got the right leg. Oh, look at this. Working on the knee. The right knee of Webb. Apparently, maybe Shane Douglas saw Webb limping earlier with that injured left knee. Maybe now making sure Webb can't walk at all in this match. And Webb, this has got to be a big concern for Webb and the Black Army in the early goings of this match. Webb already looks like he's severely injured. Now Shane Douglas in control of the match, in control of the XPW World Heavyweight Champion Webb. Suplex, textbook style coming up perhaps. Yes, snap, textbook suplex. And look at that, look, Shane Douglas holding on. Another one, once again, two of them. And look at this, rolling step suplex again. Three times, look at the elevation, the blood rushing to the head of Webb. 3, 4, 5, how many seconds? Yes, and Webb goes crashing down right in the center of the ring. Going for the pin now, perhaps a little premature. 1, 2, only 2. Senior official referee Patrick Hernandez right there to count. And look at this. Shane Douglas going for a chin lock now. Using the knee right to the back of Webb's neck, right to the external occipital protuberance area. Really wrenching away at the chin lock now, right in the center of the ring. Shane Douglas has got Webb right where he wants him, but Webb, oh. Webb trying to fight out. Look at this. Counter now from Webb. And now Veronica Kane looks very concerned. Low blow onto Shane Douglas. Webb barely getting to his feet. Kick now to the midsection with that injured knee, mind you. But Webb, the champion that he is, still fighting. Going outside of the ring, right on top of the franchise, Shane Douglas. And look at this, one of these camera cable cords now choking away. It's Shane Douglas and referee Patrick Hernandez right there, counting on the champ to break the hold ultimately. And Veronica Kane looking very concerned as well. And look at this, Webb. Whoa, Webb wants no part of Hernandez. He wants to keep his title, and you can hear the disapproval of the crowd. Look at this, Veronica Kane. Shane Douglas still conversing, the newest member. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've just joined us, the newest member of the Enterprise, the franchise, Shane Douglas, has returned to XPW. Oh, and look at this, Shane Douglas right into the ringsiders. Webb now following him up. Yes, he's got a ringside chair right to the back of Shane Douglas. Looks like he's going to swing again. Yes, right between the eyes. The sea of fans now huddling around. Clothesline from Webb onto Shane Douglas, and both these guys falling into the muck, into the dirt, into the sea of fans here in Southern California. XPW security team now trying to shoo everybody back. And I'm not talking about former Clipper head coach Gene Chu. Oh, look at that. Another chair shot right between the eyes from Shane Douglas onto Webb. Shane now with another chair. Yes, again. And Webb's out. Look at him. Stumbling, staggering about. Shane Douglas now in control. Three times right to the head of Webb. And look at this. Number 4 perhaps coming up. Yes. Oh, no. Webb with a counter. Beautiful counter that was. Desperation knee now to the midsection. Kick now to the midsection. Pounding away on the back. Webb, a house of fire. And look at this. The Boon Shoe perhaps coming into play. The karate chops as well. Now look at this, Webb with Shane Douglas right into that huge wall here at the arena. And look at this, the security railing tumbling down at the fans. And look at that, Webb right to the back of Shane Douglas with that chair once again. Both these guys still out on the arena floor, or should I say, the arena dirt. But now it's Webb with the upper hand, grabbing Shane Douglas. Oh, wait a minute. Right into the wall, and now Shane Douglas goes down right on top of that security railing that was knocked down by the sea of fans. Referee Hernandez now checking on Shane Douglas and all Veronica Kane looking very concerned right now. Her man, the one she chose from the E, the newest member, mind you, of the Enterprise to win the XPW World Heavyweight title. But Rob Black and Lizzie Borden at the ringside area too, looking very concerned. Wait a minute, from behind, Shane Douglas up on top of the security railing. Webb doesn't know where he is or where Shane Douglas is for that matter. Look at this, Webb, turn around, Webb, Shane Douglas, high cross body, and Webb goes down. Up and over, Webb. Shane Douglas now with Webb right where he wants him, outside of the ring. But he's the only way to win the title is inside of the ring. Look at this now. Oh, no, with the legs spread open. Low blow, Patrick Hernandez warning the franchise. Franchise picking up Webb now. Still on the arena floor, mind you. The franchise, look at this. Belly to back. Oh, no. Oh, crouches him right into that scaffold. That 40-foot high scaffold, and Webb is down. And that scaffold, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be seeing utilized tonight, the final of the XPW King of the Deathmatch Tournament, as the hardcore homo Angel later tonight will be going against Supreme for the 2002 King of the Deathmatch Tournament winner. And ironically, Shane came into XPW originally back in February of 2000, back in the very first King of the Deathmatch Tournament, and now he returns in the third annual. Webb. Oh no, look at this, right into the windshield of that parked car here in Southern California at the arena. Look at Shane Douglas, look at him. He wants the title. You can see it in his eyes. He's back, and Veronica King can smell the gold as well. Oh, look at that though, back body drop up and over the hood and onto the dirt. Oh, look at that. Look at the back of Shane Douglas cut by the windshield of that parked car. And these cars are literally here to be used as weapons in the Deathmatch Tournament, but they're being used as weapons here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, in the title match as well. Webb, down and out, but Shane Douglas has made it back to the squared circle with a back full of blood, ladies and gentlemen. What a laceration that is. Veronica Kane on the outside of the ring. Veronica Kane shoving Shane Douglas over to the champ, Webb. Shane Douglas picking Webb up now. Looks like he's going to, yes, throw him back into the ring. Webb covered in dirt. Shane Douglas going upstairs, it looks like. Yes, Shane Douglas up top. But Webb trying with all his might to get to his feet. Oh, he stumbled right on top of the rope. But Shane Douglas still keeping his balance. Wait a minute. Webb, oh, slams Shane Douglas from the top and on to the center of the ring. And that back is still lacerated from the windshield of the car, ladies and gentlemen. Blood is everywhere. Webb just slammed Shane Douglas on his back, on the injured back once again, where blood is just gouging out of the back itself. Now Shane Douglas with Webb, right where he wants him, Irish whip, yes, across the ropes, and look at this power slam. Webb goes down right in the center of the ring. Going for a pin perhaps. What is this, referee doubt? No. Oh, wait a minute. Wait, there's the cat. But why did he abandon the count? He might have had Webb pinned. Oh, look at this. The franchise loading up the cast now. Ready to utilize it on the champ. Look at his face. Pointing over, yes. Yes to Veronica Kane. What is this? Veronica Kane going into her. Oh, wait a minute. There's a chain. Deja vu all over again. And I'm not talking about where I was last Saturday night. Look at this. Veronica Kane, yes, handing the chain to Shane Douglas. That cash, the chain, both down. No, you got it. Oh, no, no. Webb pulled referee Patrick Hernandez right in front of him. The franchise nailed the ref. We have a major proportional problem here, ladies and gentlemen. Patrick Hernandez is out in the ringside area. We have no referee, but the title is still on the line. The chain now, about block now from Webb. Knee to the midsection, shot to the head. Irish whip coming up. Chain to the near side, to the midsection once again with that injured knee. That had to take its toll. Scoop up from Webb. Look at this going for the TCB. No! Chain brought his feet down to block it, but still, Webb got a little bit of it. Chain holding his wrist going for the pin, but there's still no ref. Oh, wait a minute. The other referee coming to the ring now. Blondie, one. Only one. Both men in tremendous amount of pain. Webb went for that TCB, but he didn't quite execute it 100%. Shane Douglas going to the near side, trying as hard as he can to get to his feet, to become the XPW World Heavyweight title with that laceration still. The blood pouring out of the back of Shane Douglas. Veronica Cain looking very nice, but also looking very, very concerned at the ringside area. Shane Douglas with Webb right in the palm of his hands. Going for Webb now. Slams him into the far side. Webb counters now with elbows to the face. Boots to the midsection. Shane still with the chain in hand. Firing Shane Douglas into the turnbuckle. Forearm shots to the back now of the franchise. The franchise once again wailing his head away. Webb continuing to pound Shane Douglas's head into the turnbuckle, because you gotta remember, and now into the canvas, you gotta remember that this match means more than just the XPW World Heavyweight title. Remember, this is a loser leaves town match, but it's also for the title. Whoever loses the match, well, we'll have to leave town, ladies and gentlemen. Shane Douglas back up, going right after Webb. Shane Douglas, where did he get this from? Belly to belly suplex, yes. And Webb goes crashing down to the center of the ring. But the lot's been taken out of Shane Douglas. Very winded as well, barely getting over for the pin. One, two, and oh, was that close. That was so close, ladies and gentlemen. We were inches away from a brand new XPW World Champ. Shane Douglas now still barely staggering to his feet. Webb is down and out. How he kicked out of that, I don't know. But look at this. Shane, he's got the chain once again. And the referee saying no, no. Blondie over here saying step off. Obviously, this new ref saw what happened. The senior official, Patrick Hernandez, he doesn't want to. And look at this. The ref telling Shane he better ditch that chain right now. He's showing who's the ref in this match because he wants this to be a clean bout. And look at this. Oh, wait a minute. No! No! That's blasphemy! That's blasphemy! Hitting an XPW official. Now two referees are down and out in this match. Webb trying to get to his feet. Headbutt to the groin. Webb picking Shane Douglas up. Spine buster. Going for the pin, but once again. Wait a minute. Referee number three. One, two. Oh, no. Only two. Felony, the ref, just barely made it to the ring. But it was only a two count. Webb, right there, inches away from retaining his title. And this is a seesaw battle, ladies and gentlemen. This match has gone back and forth. Webb, oh, look at that low blow. Webb falling back, ultimately kicking Shane right between the legs. Heel kick right to the back of the neck. Trying to roll Shane up for a pin now, yes. One, two, only two. Wait a minute, now Shane with Webb. One, two, only two again. Webb once again with the crucifix pin. No, look at this. This is back and forth, ladies and gentlemen. Shane with Webb, right where he wants him. Belly to belly. Is this going to do it? One, two, yes. Shane Douglas has won the XPW World Heavyweight Championship, and Webb's career is over. Webb must now leave town. And Shane Douglas leaves the arena with the title belt around his waist. And here comes Veronica Cain. Look at the face, of course, of Rob Black. You can't see the face of Lizzie Borden, but you can imagine what she's feeling right now. Veronica Cain, the Enterprise, is now sitting on the top of the world. Veronica Cain ready to hand. Yes, that man right there, the franchise, Shane Douglas. The XPW World Heavyweight title. I still can't believe it, ladies and gentlemen. For one, the return of the franchise, and two, we have a new champion. What the hell? Shane Douglas just headbutted Veronica King. What is this? What did she do? Wait a minute. Pittsburgh Plunge coming up. Shane Douglas, the new champ. Oh, no. What the hell's going on? It's crazy. Wait a minute. Don't tell me. Are they together on this? Rob Black laughing. Shane Douglas laughing. And Lindsay Borden. Well, I can't tell. But look at that. No. I can't believe it. What the hell? I'm going nuts. Shane Douglas just turned on Kane and then Rob Black. Lindsay Borden. Wait a minute. With the belt. No, once again, right between the eyes. Very standoffish now, Lindsay Borden. She better watch out. Shane Douglas with the title. What the hell is Dorco Dude doing out here? Kevin Kleinrock, Vice President of Operations here in Extreme Professional Wrestling. And what's in the briefcase? And Kevin Kleinrock, I don't know if he didn't just see what happened. He's very calm right now, despite all the carnage and all the mayhem we just witnessed here at Night of Champions. Shane Douglas laid out Kane, laid out Rob Black, and now Lindsay Borden, you better watch out. He's gonna lay you out too. What is this? The mask is off. What the? There's nothing wrong with her face at all. What is going on? What the hell is going on?
And you.
You piece of shit.
A divorce!
Kevin, this shouldn't have been made possible without you, my friend. Look at your Rob Black, who brought you XPW, who you sat up there and cheered for and rallied behind and paid your hard-earned greenbacks to support. Well, he's laying in a bloody piece of shit up because the franchise just franchised his ass.
I don't know what to make of this. What the hell? What the hell can happen, Daddy?
Put your hands on me. We are taking this company back to where they know what wrestling is. Back to the East Coast. And you, California, pieces of can wave XPW goodbye. August 31st, the guy who made ECW Extreme makes the ECW arena XPW's new home, the XPW arena. Now hit my f***ing music.
The franchise, Shane Douglas, the new XPW World Heavyweight Champion, is bringing XPW to the old ECW arena August 31st. In Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, as we see the new XPW World Heavyweight title belt around the waist. Oh my goodness, look at this. Shane Douglas, the new champion, along with Lindsay Borden, turning his back on Rob Black. But first it was Black that turned his back on Webb. Then Kevin Kleinrock turned his back on Black, and then the franchise turned his back on Shane. Damn it, I don't know what the hell's going on. All I can say is Shane Douglas is now the new world champion. Rob Black, an apparent divorce with Lindsay Borden.
But we have a new champion. It's the franchise, Shane Douglas. And there's going to be no more.
No more Webb. As he just lost the loser leaves town match, he's gone from XPW. More than just the title he lost. Oh, wait a minute, XPW security rushing over. We got some livid fans. We got some pissed off fans here in the arena. They just found out that XPW is gone. Vominos from Los Angeles, California, and it's found its new home in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Folks, that's all I can tell you. All I know is we have a brand new XPW World Heavyweight Champion in the franchise, Shane Douglas, and we have a new home. XPW has a new home, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Rob Black down, Veronica Kane down. Where does this leave Kane? Where does this leave Black ultimately? Where does this leave XPW? So many lives change in this match as Webb walks off for the final time out of an XPW arena show. His career is now over. Rob Black down and out. XPW, where the hell do we stand? So many lives, so many careers, all changed in just one match.
Fans, we are just 3 weeks away from Hostile Takeover, Saturday night, August the 31st, as XPW makes its East Coast debut in the former ECW, now XPW Arena in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Now, for the West Coast fans watching right now, we want to shout out a special thanks to you all. And by showing our appreciation here in XPW, for the West Coast fans making the trip out to Philadelphia, you're going to be admitted to a pre-show special autograph signing as XPW says thank you, Los Angeles. And the LA fans' response has been tremendous for this one. Now, tickets are on sale right now. You can call the XPW box office at 1-866-888-4336. Or, of course, you can log on to xpwrestling.com for Saturday night, August the 31st in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, as XPW presents Hostile Takeover. And now all titles will be on the line. Chaos will be defending the XPW World Television title against Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick in a final rematch, ladder match, and apparently Terry Funk will be heading to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania to challenge Shane Douglas for the XPW World Heavyweight title. Supreme will be defending the XPW King the Deathmatch title, and Super Crazy will be making his XPW debut as he'll be taking on Psychosis. All that and a whole lot more coming to you live Saturday night, August the 31st, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, as XPW presents Hostile Takeover. Now, for all you West Coast fans that have been with us for the past 3 years, be sure to tell all the folks you know on the East Coast that they can catch XPW TV, No Sleep Till Philly, every Friday night at 2 a.m. on WGTW, and starting September the 2nd, and every Monday night thereafter on WGTW at 12 midnight, XPW presents Monday Nightmare. And for all the fans here in Los Angeles, California, this is Chris Gloss saying we'll see you next week right here on Chris Gloss's XPW TV.
Nice living in this house. You should drive a black Mercedes. I was somebody. Now, come on. Hey, hardcore homo! Glad to see you up and around. Okay, what are you doing laying here next to this thing? Angel, I've been looking for you. I went to Webb's apartment.
Exactly.
What?
Webb's apartment.
Do you see where I have to live now?
What?
No, it's sold.
Really?
Gone. Okay? And I came by and they had this in the trash. Some fans, I don't know who the hell they are. This is in the trash. So I'm just laying here, just like one last, you know, remembrance. I mean, do you see where I'm staying? That dog that Webb's got just pisses all over the house, man.
Yes, yeah, I've met him.
I mean, it's like I'll be sleeping like this, and there'll be on me.
He tried to hump me. Now, I just like males humping me, but dogs are just another thing I don't do, okay?
Angel, but listen. Angel, can you believe it? Okay, she took everything, man. All right? Can you believe she took the condo in Nantucket?
Oh, I love that. I love that condo. Hey, you know what? I used to know a man from Nantucket.
Oh, I know. I've heard that joke before. Okay.
What?
I know his was so big he could suck it. What?
It's true, though. I met him.
Yes. What do you want?
Well, I mean, listen.
And after September 1st, I'm done in XPW.
What do you mean?
Done. Everything starts September 1st, all right? I'm done. Owner, nothing. I'm nothing. The only thing I got is Extreme Associates. I lost all the companies, everything. I don't know what's going to happen to all you guys.
With the Black Army, we're still together.
There is no Black Army, Angel. You know what, man? Hey, who? You? Webb can't wrestle anymore. Me? I'm just me. As soon as she takes control, she's going to throw my ass out of the company. What are you going to do, the hardcore homo? That's the army. The homo army. How's that? Listen. The homo army.
Listen, so you say you still have power up to September 1st, right?
Yes.
So I guess you can still make matches if you wanted to?
Yeah, it's who cares.
Please, make this match for me. I want that belt that's rightfully mine. I want Supreme in a death match for his title. My title. You know it's my title.
You wouldn't
want. If that stupid Shane Douglas wouldn't have shot me, I would have that belt wrapped around my waist, and I would have, you know what? That's all I would have. No blue pants.
All right. It's a good idea. All right. Because I can still do. All right. That Philly show, you're wrestling Supreme.
For the
king of the deathmatch title. Thumbtacks, barbed wire, just glass, everything.
Okay. Well.
Okay. Can I be with Tyrone now?
Okay?
I'll be all right. I'm go tell Webb to make me some dinner tonight. I'm sick of eating macaroni and cheese. You know what I mean, Tyrone? I can get you some watermelon. Yeah. It's good watermelon.